want to show you guys something that we're going to start implementing into our classrooms here at Washington State University. What it is, it's called a desktop learning module. And what it allows us to do is to bring hands-on learning into the classroom. So instead of just seeing equations on the board, and you can actually see the real thing, only miniaturized. And so the idea now is to take the models that you're using, the mathematical models, and see how they fit into a real system. It's telling us that it's a cross flow. It knows it's got a little card. Each one of these has a little card on there, you'll see. And those cards are read by the system, and then it displays what kind of heat exchanger it is, what kind of fluid mechanics system it is. And then we can scroll down, and it tells you the flow rate. And what we do here is we just turn up the flow rate to whatever value you want. You can see that what's happening. Okay, scroll down. And then it also has the battery voltage. So very important, you know, if you're using this in the classroom, it's battery powered. You don't have to have plug-ins, but you do need to recharge the battery, and it tells you. We've got a shell and tube heat exchanger. There's tubes dangling out here, and they gotta go somewhere. And so what we would do is we plug them into a second base unit. One could be warm, one could be cool, okay? Typically you'll have the warmer water on the inside. Obviously, it's a fluidized bed module. It can work as a packed bed. You can see that it's got gradations here so that it starts at some height. And we can actually turn up the flow rate until it begins to flow and just back it down a little bit and get it down as far as we can and then read a pressure drop across that system where it's just barely fluidized or even where it's not fluidized, you can get a pressure drop. But here you can see the bed expands, you know, normally what you would see with a fluidized bed. It is a fluidized bed, so that's what you would expect. And we can measure the pressure drops across there. Of course, once it's fluidized, pressure drop is constant.